Down like four more, so that's gonna be 12 carriers. A couple void rays, shit ton. You don't, you never need this many cannons. But yeah, I guess he wants to, I guess he feels unsecure about his defense right now, and he wants to move out with the carriers while leaving his base protected by a shit ton of cannons. Anyway, so looks like I am starting to finish mining out my natural expansion. I have a decent sizable army, about two large pages of units, banshees, I mean not banshees, but phoenixes, stalkers, sentries, maybe like one zealot, nope, no zealots at all, some observers, and he's got a line of supply depots, Tony does. Like, we got a couple more carriers in the mix, as well as that mothership is still there. And at this point, we have Ryan, who's trying to rebuild his Corruptor Ultralisk army. He did go for this build, but it didn't really work out, especially in that last engagement where I kind of like walled him off, and all my ground army killed his Corruptors anyway, so. And I think Corruptors are, yeah, they do good damage against massive, so these are pretty much like the carrier counters in some ways, or in a lot of ways, carriers and like battle cruisers. So anyway, and maybe like Colossi, I guess. But at this point, I know that he has got a shit ton of carriers, but I don't care. Just want to see how many I can kill right now before anything happens. I try to snipe the mothership as quick as possible, doesn't really snipe it too well. At this point, I've already lost a shit ton of units, and as you can see, it's pretty impossible to tell like what's under there, but I'm pretty much losing units left and right. These couple of these cannons, like five cannons, doing so much damage against this, as well as the carriers. But I took out most of the carriers, which is fairly a successful, you know, push at this point, because I got warp gates, I've got more stalkers coming out, I got a couple stalkers here. No, I don't. Well, I do have cannons up here. This is for my high yield, which I don't have working up yet. I do save one stalker, hero stalker, on the way back with no kills, no kill to show, but he's gonna be lying about that when he's talking to his stalker buddies, who are not looking at him in any way. And on this side, we have Thor ships going out for Tony. He does have a couple medevacs here. I don't think he really realizes that the medevacs don't heal Thors yet, but he does have a couple of marines and marauders stored in those oh, he has a Reaper, that's kind of random. Stored in those. So he drops onto Poppy's high yield. And at this point, Poppy wants to get some revenge, even though he knows he can't really defend this. Although, he can defend this. As long as he stays on the high ridge, just does a little micro, you can kill those Thors, no problem. Because Thors take a lot of damage from single targets. But actually, he goes here. I guess he A-moved about to my natural, and then ended up you know, pretty much attacking Tony's planetary fortress. I guess he's trying to hunt down that planetary fortress now. A couple more ravens coming out, going to the center. I got a couple units trying to snipe some corruptors here. A little bit of miss micro for Ryan here, because he's just pretty much sending his corruptors up here to get owned. But I back off too, since I see some carriers on this side. I kind of move back just so I can get position on him, because he's on that high ridge, he has the advantage. He could just move back in some sense. But here we go, I'm pretty much just sniping his carriers one by one, as you can see. Pew 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 pew. And this is what you want to do against carriers. You just want to snipe them, pretty much just attack the carrier. You have to micro in this situation, otherwise you're going to be attacking those interceptors like no tomorrow, doing absolutely no damage, because those interceptors are very effective against like computers or something who don't micro. I got a couple Thors here which are taking out Poppy's main, which pretty much only has cannons. So if, yeah, he does drop a couple auto turrets here, but if he dropped one Thor here, that would pretty much be the end at this point. And we got a couple Corruptors and Ultralisks, about six Ultralisks now, so Ryan does definitely have a decent sized army, but as I can see, he does have this expansion, but I need more money. Everyone, I need more money. So I'm going to be killing this expansion as soon as I can. Or pretty much just sniping it, get Ryan's attention here. Even though I just got attacked by carriers. He does a little bit of a miss micro, sending in those photon cannons. I mean, those corruptors into the Falcon cannons. I'm pretty sure he said, oh shit, at that point, or like, wow, bullshit. But at this point, pretty much just a microfest right here, seeing who can look at each other the hardest. He does go in through the Nidus network, and he pops the Nidus network right below my expansion. My natural expansion. Got a couple of Zealots warping in him for some reason. And at this point, Thors have taken out Poppy's base. Thors versus cannons. Thors will win. A couple Marauders there too, so yeah, here we go. I'm just popping out here, killing his expansion a little, not really anything special. But those Corruptors pretty much can't kill this army, so he's pretty much at a downside here. I do notice at this point that there are Ultralisks hammering away at my base, so I got some Zealots here to try and take care of this. Better idea would have probably been to go Dark Templars, but I'm pretty much streaming my units back down, and this many units will kill all those Ultralisks, no problem. About 8 Ultralisks, I guess. Yeah, 8 Ultralisks. Yeah, Ultralisks in this game are like way too bulky now, so they're not that effective. And a couple decent placed force fields, leaving those Ultralisks completely sandwiched in between those Dark Templars. That's some pretty sweet micro, if you ask me. And those Corruptors are in a bad location at this moment, because these Ultralisks are gonna die, and there's gonna be no ground army to kind of take care of. Actually, he just moves it out. I didn't remember that, but yeah. At this point, I know I'm like ahead of Ryan at this point, and I know Poppy has, you know, pretty much lost his base, but at this stage of the game, I'm fairly worried about what Tony has, because I have yet to really scan his base for a scout. I do have these Zealots, which completely take out, like, I don't know how much, but got a couple SCVs in the bunker. That's not what SCV bunkers are for, but yeah, he's got a couple Ravens here, about 8 Ravens. Wow, that's a lot. And Dushan here is just freely scouting. I'm not going to kill him or anything, because I know he has only that left anyway. So, not sure what happens here at this point, but I do have a decent sizable income. Actually, I have the best income right now, which kind of, I guess, is because the high yield. Since I've been running at 4 bases and defending them, like, pretty much indefinitely, I've never actually lost a base, whereas Tony has lost his natural, Dushan has lost his, Dushan is Poppy, has lost his high yield, like, twice, lost his pretty much whole base, and as well, Ryan has completely mained out at his base and natural and barely has any drones here, which is an issue. All these drones could be mining right here and that would be so much more effective for him. But as you can see here, I'm going in for a final blow to the stomach onto Ryan here. I got some... He's got his Corruptors, but I've got my Phoenixes and my pretty much whole ground army, which will take care of it. But I do notice that he does have a couple Broodlords now, or just 1-2 Broodlords. And at this point I say dot. I don't know why. Probably a mistake. Probably a mistake. And as you can see, I'm just bringing back my army here, but pretty much just amassing more forces, picking some more up, regrouping them, and Tony here has... Look at those! Look at that! What the hell is that? Just look at those Thors! Couple Ravens here. Wow. I don't know what happened to those Ravens here, actually. I have to take a note of that later. And looks like Dushan here is just kinda, you know, kinda pretty much basing up again, walling in with a forge. Probably gonna go more cannons. And looks like we got a bunch of Corruptors here, a couple Broodlords. Had he gone Broodlords before instead of Ultralisks, it probably would have helped him a lot more, because Broodlords are really effective. Although they're a lot more effective against like larger units and buildings, but they're still very effective in general, because basically whenever Broodlords shoot, they're the new Guardians by the way, whenever they shoot down they send out like 2 of these tiny Broodlings, which are kind of like mini Zerglings, which do a decent amount of damage, and I go for a little bit of a sniper harass, or a little bit of a snipe on some SCVs here. I do see those Thors coming out, so I figure at this point he's probably coming for me. And yeah, just broke the rocks for him, I guess. I don't know why, but yeah, got my army here just waiting in the corner, waiting on the side. My Phoenix is floating right above his base. He's got some Corruptors and Broodlords at this point, Ryan does, and I guess he's trying to figure he can, if he can destroy this, take this natural, take this area, he'll be somewhat okay, but I pretty much mined out this high yield at this point. So as you can see, those are raping those buildings, like, there's a couple corruptors. They're not even attacking it, actually, but those